Okay. Hello, everyone. I'm here with Øyvind Nyhus of Molde Underwater Rugby Club. And one of the key elements of underwater rugby is fast swimming. And one of the key parts of fast swimming is knowing how to swim with your core body strength and use your fins properly. And Øyvind is a national record holder in Norway. And although he's not competing actively right now, he figures that he still has good enough times to win medals in international competition. And could you tell us a little bit what underwater rugby players should do in order to swim faster?
Yeah, I have to start to interrupt you at that. I talk about age group. I'm an extremely old guy, and in my age group, yes, but not in the level that the best Russian and Chinese junks do. I'm not near at all. To do swim fast in underwater rugby, I think you have to need both endurance technique and speed, explosivity. And about endurance training, most of the endurance training in underwater rugby, the hard one is more specific is underwater rugby playing. But we can't play every day because then we get injured. So we have to build a base on some hours every week with another endurance training. In our club, still it's more and less what it's each player is more most have the guts for. But I think in the future in underwater rugby, everyone have to do fin swimming, and do fin swimming like long distance surface as an endurance base, not on very high intensity, and do sprint training as well. And for good sprints, you have to be flexible. You have to do flexibility training every day in shoulders and hips and your back, because you have to get free in the cyclus. You have to get a good cyclus and have the streamline in your body, so it's not the big frontal water. So you just flow into water. And you also have to do a lot of strength training, because now we play with the fins that more or less similar, that the hardness is more or less similar that do in fin swimming. And that have to do a lot of deadlift and stuff like that to get core body strength, to get strength in your hips. And you also have to do a lot of sprint training with fins. When you do sprint training with fins, you have to, I think it's best to do with the goggles, not the mask, the goggles and streamline position underwater. And you have to get the right technique and feeling without fins, so you can see that your movement is right. If you do it without fins, you see more difference when those who's fast who do it right and those who's not fast. So if you find the technique without fins first, and then start with swimmers, rugby fins, and monofin, and you have to wechsel about training with all this equipment and do sprints, short sprints with good speed, and also a little bit underwater with technique, and maybe a little bit technique training with arms alongside the body, so your hips movement get big enough. Yeah.
And do you have trouble convincing underwater rugby players to make the commitment to fin swim training?
It's not a professional sport yet. So I think in the future, if you get some money in it, and the restitution times work, everyone don't have to work all the time and stuff like that, the more of the endurance training and sprint training could be in fellas trainings. And then the coach have to decide what they do. Nowadays, everyone see that if you get to want to be a world level player, you have to play underwater rugby, and you have to lift weights, and you have to do endurance and sprint training. And nowadays, I think a lot of rugby players jogging, mountain hiking, cycling, swimming, and do a different. And for the motivation, it's good to do different. But if you want to do the endurance and sprint training, most specific for underwater rugby, I think everyone have to do more fin swimming, both in surface and underwater. Surface with the front snorkel and underwater sprints.
So you wouldn't be using your underwater rugby fiberglass fins, you'd be using some rubber fins, swim fins, the ones that swimmers use, and then the monofin.
I think you have to do different equipment, because as I told you, to get the right feeling, to see what your hips do, and what your toes do, and the coordination between it, you have to see what speed you can get without anything. When you have the good speed without anything, as the swimmer in underwater kick after butterfly backstroke freestyle, so you get that good speed and take your take on monofin, you can do the same with a monofin. And the best equipment to do specific sprint running in streamline is monofin, the most expensive monofins with the new technology that came 15 years ago. They cost a lot, but then you have most of the power in your hips and not your quadriceps. Because what most rugby players maybe do a little wrong is that they have a lot of power through the quadriceps, and that get too hard to get a new sprint, a new sprint, a new sprint during a game, and maybe the lactate acid get too high. You can get as the same speed, but it costs more energy. So, but if you have the train a lot with the most expensive monofins, that make you feel that you're just flowing in the water, that all the power gets through your hips, and use the same technique in underwater rugby, I think you can save some energy and just have the same speed.
So we know that Amanda Barstan is still winning medals in conventional regular swimming, and how good is her underwater swimming?
Amanda is a very good underwater swimmer. She's winning medals in masters swimming from 25-29. And her strength is underwater in butterfly kicking. After in sprint 50 butterfly, 100 individual medley, she's a good swimmer, and her strength is underwater.
So that helps her in underwater rugby a lot?
A lot, yes, of course.
And Iver Bjørnerem, he's very fast. What are his strengths as a swimmer?
Iver was, when he was young, he was a butterfly swimmer. He do about 101 in butterfly, but he has a too heavy body to swim extremely fast. But in underwater rugby, he's have a natural flexibility in shoulders, so his streamline during underwater is very good. So and his power extreme. He did 200 and I don't know 40, 50 in deadlift. So his power through the fins is enormous. Yeah.
And do you clock and record the times for multi players in underwater swimming in order to set goals for improvement?
No, we don't do that now. But earlier, we had when I was coaching the national team until 2003, we have this 50-meter underwater tests in every training session. Not every training session, but every weekend we meet, and yeah. But then, back then, we still do the plastic fins. So I don't know how fast it's going now. But back then, I was the fastest, about 20 seconds, 0.7 or something, in underwater with the plastic fins.
Stratos, 50 meters.
Stratos, yes, yes. But still, if you do the monofin, you can do 17 seconds, maybe the fastest rugby player do that. And with the fiber fins, I don't know. Maybe a little faster. The technique will don't be as good as with plastic fins because they are a little bit unstable in the water. They do like that, but the power in the into the basket and stuff is extremely different than with the plastic fins. So I don't know how fast this is.
Well, the Mirena fin company in Hungary, they don't play very much underwater rugby, but they hope that underwater rugby players will use their fins. So they sent the fins as prizes because they want to spread that idea, and you'll be able to try them out and say what you think about them, because you're not using them all the time now.
No.
The bifins.
What?
The rubber fins,
yeah.
The ones that you got as the prize.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah.
So.
Yes, it's about under rugby. It's not all about speed. When the hard fins came, the fiber fins came, we get so much power into the door, into the situations. When we hit an opponent, we hit it harder. When you hit the basket and the goalkeeper, we hit it harder. And it's well as much as that, and that the top speed. So I think we still have to need what we have used now the last 10 years, the power from behind when we meet something and crush into something. It's important.
Explosivity.
Explosivity, yes.
So what else should we cover before we go down to see Clara and Puk, your students?
I don't understand the question.
Is there anything else you want to talk about before?
It's okay.
We'll go down.
We're
going down to see Clara and Puk, who are going to show Øyvind what they've got.
Yeah, okay.
Thank you.